My name is Mark Tollison, and I'm the coordinator of piano and music theory at the University of North Carolina at Pembroke. In this video, we're going to talk about music theory. Music is a language, and like in any language, you must learn to write it, read it, speak it, and hear it. You are already fluent speakers and hearers of music. The music theory courses in college will therefore help you to read and write it more effectively. So here are four things that you can do today to help prepare you for college music theory courses. In your English classes when you were younger, you spent a lot of time studying letters and words and grammar. Similarly, we will spend a lot of time studying the small units of music, like the note, the chord, and the chord progression in our college music theory courses. It will help, though, if you can begin to understand some of the larger structures of music, like the phrase, while still in high school. A phrase is a group of notes that, when combined, create a musical thought. With practice, hearing phrases can become quite easy. The Star Spangled Banner is a great example. Here we have musical fragments that match directly with the lyrics. Oh, say, can you see? By the dawn's early light. Those two fragments combined create a phrase. What so proudly we hailed? At the twilight's last gleaming. Again, two fragments that create a musical phrase. The song What a Wonderful World is another excellent example. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. That's a phrase. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Again, we have two smaller fragments making up a musical phrase, and then followed by another two smaller fragments making up a musical phrase. Listen actively rather than passively for phrases in the music that you're hearing at home. The majority of instrumental, vocal, and even pop music uses phrases similar to what we just saw. Another thing that you can do right now to help prepare for college music theory is to memorize your key signatures. Once you're in college, we'll help you to learn why key signatures are the way they are and how they relate to each other. But your task for now is to simply memorize them. So for example, if you see a key signature of four sharps, you know instantly that that's either E major or C sharp minor. Get together with your friends and quiz each other on key signatures. Ask your high school teacher how you can build scales from the key signatures. If you can name your key signatures now, you'll be in great shape when you start college music theory. Pentascales are five-note scales built from whole steps and half steps. Learning to play these on the piano now will help you understand chord construction better once you're in a college music theory course. A half step is the distance between adjacent notes on the piano. Here, here, here to here, here to here, here to here. Those are all half steps, and so on. A whole step is two half steps combined. On the piano, it's two notes with one note in between. That's a whole step. That's a whole step. That's a whole step. And so on. The major pentascale has two whole steps, then one half step, and then one more whole step. Whole step, whole step, half step, whole step. Practice your major pentascales by playing them first ascending and then descending on the piano, and then playing the first, third, and fifth notes together as a chord. When you're comfortable with that, move everything up a half step to C sharp or D flat and do the same pattern. keep moving it up a half step each time until you reach C again. Music likely originated with the human voice, and melodies ever since have been influenced by it. No matter whether you're a violist, percussionist, saxophonist, or singer, your music theory teacher in college is going to ask you to sing, and they're going to ask you to sing a lot. If you can become comfortable singing now, it will not only make you well prepared for college music theory courses, it will make you a better overall musician. So I encourage you to practice the UNCPs of theory before coming to college. If you can understand phrasing, name your key signatures, construct pentascales, and practice singing, you'll be in great shape for college music theory courses.